All right. Ladies and gentlemen, a man who recently on social media admitted Justin Timberlake was the GOAT, Paul Clemente.
Justin Timberlake is the GOAT. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Paul.
Hey. Since I have a lot of time, I have a couple jokes that don't make it anywhere besides my notebook, and I'm just going to go over those guys. They're really bad, so if you guys want to hear them, I'll tell them. You guys good with that? Some of these were written under the influence, some of them were not. All of them were written under the influence. That's why they don't make it past my notebook. But, aren't birds just born for tents? No? Yes? And what do dogs call other dogs? Isn't the letter Q just a gay O? When little people smoke weed, they don't get high, they get medium. I saw a billboard for milk. That's it, I saw a billboard for milk. Someone at the milk company said we need to sneak to get the word out there. Also in the marketing world, somewhere, at some time, in some place, someone sat down a whole boardroom full of executives of a multi-million dollar company and pitch the idea of a slogan of pizza, pizza, and made millions.
Yeah.
That's true. Those are all my shitty jokes.
I like them.
That's all right. That's all right. That would suck if that was it. Even though it's a free show, I think you guys can get pissed. So I'm going to tell real jokes. If anyone wants to do improv, I'm still doing improv Mondays at the Spire Theater, or at the Chapel Theater at the Spire Building. Any of you are invited if you want to practice improv or just have some fun. It's a good time, isn't it? Good time?
Yep.
All right, cool. It's a good time. Everyone's good. You don't have to be experienced. You don't have to have had it done before. Just come out and have some fun. So last weekend, I took my kids to the pool. And it's such a big deal for me, because when I was a kid, I basically lived in a pool. I grew up in a pool. My parents actually dropped me off every day at noon in the summer, picked me up at 5, gave us all $1 to eat lunch at the snack bar, and that was it. She was done with us. And for 5 hours, she got to pretend that she didn't have kids. Every summer at the pool, me and my brother and my sister, every single day. So it was nice being back there. It kind of makes me a little nostalgic. So I was basically raised by lifeguards from 10 to 15. Those were the people I asked questions about, and those are the people who taught me the birds and the bees and all the good stuff. And once I turned 15, the second I was allowed, I became a lifeguard, so I became one of them, and I lifeguarded until I was 21. So I was basically lived at a pool my entire childhood. And when you just do that, and you're a lifeguard for 6 years, it just sticks with you. And when you're at the pool, you think, you see all the little things that other people do, and you're like, yeah, I get it. Like, when I see someone running at the mall, I still tell them to walk. And I realize, hey, it's, just get out of my head, it's a little PTSD. So, I want you guys to be honest with me. Who here pees in the pool?
Every time.
Seriously,
I ain't getting out.
See, now one brave person raises their hand. Do you pee in the pool? Yeah, see, everyone pees in the pool. It makes no sense to me why people are very, reserved about it. I pee in the pool every single time, all the time. If someone tells you that they have chemicals in the pool that make your piss turn different color, they don't exist. It's an urban legend, they lied to you. You are allowed to pee in the pool. Those chemicals are put to handle things a lot worse than pee. And I've done a lot worse things in the pool than pee. But you can just pee in the pool as much as you want. In fact, when researching these jokes, I've peed in over 50 bodies of water. So through my time from growing up in a pool and being everywhere, I've been on swim teams, I've coached swimming, I've taught swim lessons, I've worked at pools, up, down. I have peed, I swam all the way up to college. So I peed at the University of Pittsburgh, I peed in their pool. Penn State, I've peed in their pool. Slippery Rock, I've peed in their pool. I've peed at four different YMCAs, 26 high schools, 12 private clubs, 14 hotels, resorts, and water parks, 4 lakes, and 1 ocean.
You peed in Slippery Rock?
Yeah, the peed right
in Slippery Rock.
Maybe not at the same time.
Yeah.
And you know what's funny? I could have told you guys, I could have made up anything, but I looked that up because it was a lot funnier. I went on Google Maps, I called my mom to find out where I went as a kid. I had a notebook and I put little stars next to places I peed because it would have been funnier to actually know how many places I peed. So I took my kids to the pool, and the first thing I do is I look for the fattest guy there. Just the fattest guy, I look all over the place, real nervous, and as soon as I see him, I feel a lot better about myself. Especially because I'm wearing a shirt. If you see a guy that's bigger than me not wearing a shirt, I feel good. I take my shirt off, I enjoy the day. If not, I leave it on. Because if there's always a guy bigger than me, if there's a guy bigger than me, I can be like, oh, you know, you might not like what's going on here, but look at that guy with mustard crusted on his chest hair and he's chugging Mountain Dew. Like, I feel better about myself. And that's the first thing I do. I get neurotic about it. I look all the way down. I look at him, I check the snap bar, and I see him, and he has 2 hot dogs, and I'm like, all right, cool, I feel better. I take my shirt off. So, from growing up in a pool to going to a pool now, it's weird how, you know, it's maybe been about 20 years since, like, my pool days till now, maybe less. And it's weird how a lot of things change, and, like, rules have evolved, and laws have evolved. Like, you can't dive anywhere. Anywhere in any pool. It's no diving the whole way around. You can't dive. It used to be, well, it is now in Pennsylvania, it's 8 feet minimum to dive head first anywhere. And if you're doing competitions, it's 6 feet. When I was a kid, the minimum was, is there water? That's all you had to do. I remember when I was 9, I was at a swim meet and we were doing a relay and we had to dive into 3 feet of water. No issues there. And I remember just diving down, I didn't tuck my head, I went straight down, I scraped the end of my nose really hard. And I came up to breathe, and there's this blood coming down my face, I look like Andy W.K. Just blood dripping down my face. And I looked at my coach, and he's on the side, and he's cheering everyone on. He looks at me, and he just gives me the, face. And I thought, you know, do I get out? And then he just looks at me, he's like, go, 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 what are you doing? So things have changed from that to not being able to dive anywhere. Also, when I was a lifeguard, kids weren't allowed to have floaties at all. Because they thought if you're in a pool, you should know how to fucking swim. Like, they weren't forbidden, because they didn't want people counting on those things, because floaties can get deflated and things can break and kids will go down. Because parents will just, you know, send them out there. I saw a kid in the 4 feet, he had a life jacket on him, 4 feet of water. He had pool floaties, and he had like a waist buoy, all at once. And how much fun is this kid gonna have? He couldn't move. He was like the kid from Christmas Story. He was just all puffed up. And they put him in there, and he floated like Sandra Bullock from Gravity, just lost in space. He was just floating. He couldn't move. He was just at the mercy of all the other kids' splashes. And then as much as, you know, the duality of it all, as much as things change, as much as things stay the same, like everyone's seen that one weird kid that's by himself, no friends, no parents, just doing handstands. They just do handstands for 5 hours, just by themselves, doing handstands, putting their feet up, and that's all that they do. They sit on the adults swim, they sit there patiently, look around, no one around them, they get back in, they just do handstands. The whole time, just constant handstands. I saw that kid. There's also, you know, once adult swim happens, there's always those old ladies, you know, they swim and they get in your way. And then, there is one thing after adult swim, is, you know, everyone knows when a dad gets in the pool, a new dad. Because the kids scream, dads have this weird chemical reaction in their brains once it comes to a pool, they just, it all rolls out the window, they cannonball on top of a pile of kids, they're picking them up, they're choke slamming them, they're spinning them around. And you can't do that. You can't do that now. They don't trust you. Like back then they used to trust you with your own child's well-being. Like you get in there and you get that superhuman strength that you get in the pool, so you can like real press kids, turning the Hulk Hogan, you're slamming them, you're picking them up, you're powerbombing them, and you can't do that anymore. And that used to be a window. Used to be able to take all that frustration from all the like discarded Christmas presents, all the tantrums in the store, all the piles of clothes on them, and you could just manifest that into violence, and you couldn't hurt them, but it was just like your outlet. And now you can't do that. They've taken that away from you. And so when you're slamming the kids and you're feeling invincible, it's inevitable. And this happens in playgrounds too. When you're picking up the kids, you're having a good time, you draw a lot of attention to yourself, you feel that extra set of hands. And then someone else's fucking weird kid just glomming onto your good time. And these kids have no parents, they're just dying for any kind of attention. And they just get on there, you're playing with your kid, you're having a good time, you're throwing, and then there's this weird fucking kid on you. And then he looks at you and says something weird like that. Throwing you, daddy? You're like, ew. I can barely tolerate my own kid, and there's this strange, weird kid he wants to be in on you. Last year, my son's jumping off, he's getting over his fear, jumping off the deep end, and jumping in the pool, and I'm catching him, jumping in the pool, and I'm catching him. And this weird, gross, red-headed kid, and I'm sorry if anyone has red-headed kids, but this one was particularly gross, like with the teeth that were all fucked up, and just like snot dripping down, and he was dirty somehow, and he was already still in the pool, and he was still dirty. I don't know how that happened. It was just like a joke that was one shot. And I'm catching my son, and I'm seeing this kid, and he sees us having a good time. He goes walking on over, couldn't even walk right because he's so free and just whatever. And I'm catching my kid, and all of a sudden he just jumps. He runs and jumps towards me, and I wasn't ready for him. So instinctually, I sidestepped him. I let this kid hit the fucking water as hard as he could. And he was stunned. He thought I was going to catch him. And so I look over, and his eyes are this big, and he was going down. And so all my lifeguard training kicked in from back in the day. And I look at my son, I'm like, hey, you want to go get a hot dog? That's unfortunately it for me. So thanks very much.